Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome back to Morgellons Discussion and Microscopy Videos. I'm tired, but we're going to do a quick episode today talking about the ChatGPT and what it has to say in response to our questions regarding Morgellons disease. I've just been working out a little bit too much. You know, last week was beautiful, and so I took the opportunity to play disc golf 6 days in a row. It'd been a long time since I've been able to do that and have that kind of energy, but man, it feels good to finally get there. So, in case you're wondering, yes, there is a way back from Morgellons, but you have to take the appropriate measures and ensure that's exactly what you're dealing with. So I got on the ChatGPT today, which is a brand new experience. This is AI answering all sorts of questions and I guess garnering the information for its responses from the internet. And I think it does a pretty good job of giving balanced and measured responses. There were some answers that ChatGPT gave to me that I just did not agree with. And the fortunate thing about that program is that you can participate. If you get an answer that you don't think is particularly beneficial or accurate, you can give them feedback on what you think it could have said to make it better. I asked it a few questions and I wanted to just take time to go over those and read them here to you on this show. If you haven't already subscribed, feel free to join us. If you'd like to become a member, that would help me out financially. Hey, if you're already a member and you just want to say thanks and send me some cash, you know you can always do that. All right, so first of all, what causes Morgellons? And ChatGPT told me, Morgellons is a controversial condition characterized by the presence of unusual fibers or particles in and on the skin, as well as a range of other symptoms such as skin lesions, itching, crawling sensations, and fatigue. The cause of Morgellons is not well understood, and it remains a topic of debate among medical professionals and researchers. Some experts believe Morgellons is a psychiatric condition, with symptoms that arise from a combination of psychological and environmental factors. They suggest that the fibers and particles are a product of skin picking or self-injury, or that they may be environmental contaminants that adhere to the skin. Others believe that Morgellons is a real physical condition, with an underlying medical cause. Several studies have found evidence of underlying infections, such as Lyme disease, and some have identified the fibers and particles as biological in nature, suggesting that they may be related to an infectious agent or immune dysfunction. Despite ongoing research into the causes of Morgellons, there is no universally accepted explanation for the condition. As a result, many healthcare providers may be hesitant to diagnose or treat it, and those who do may take different approaches based on their own beliefs and experiences. I thought that answer was interesting because it says that different practitioners have different beliefs regarding Morgellons, and the purpose of science is to dissolve belief in favor of evidence. Instead of believing something, you can think something because you have the evidence to make it a tangible scenario. It's something that you can show others because of the evidence that's there. You don't have to say, hey, you just need to trust me and believe me that this is the way it's going to be, because that usually gets people in trouble. All right, so moving forward, the next question I asked ChatGPT was, how strong is the evidence that Morgellons is a real condition? And here's what it told me. The existence of Morgellons as a distinct medical condition is a topic of controversy in the medical community, and the evidence for its existence is not universally accepted. Some medical professionals believe that Morgellons is a psychiatric condition, while others believe that it is a real physical condition with an underlying medical cause. Those who believe that Morgellons is a real condition often cite the presence of unusual fibers or particles in and on the skin, as well as a range of other symptoms, such as skin lesions, itching, crawling sensations, and fatigue, as evidence of its physical nature. However, much of the research on Morgellons is limited by small sample sizes, lack of standardized diagnostic criteria, and methodological limitations. Some studies have reported the presence of unusual fibers or particles in skin samples from individuals with Morgellons, but other studies have not been able to replicate these findings, or have suggested that the fibers may be environmental contaminants or artifacts of skin picking. In conclusion, while there is some evidence to suggest that Morgellons may be a real condition, the evidence is not strong enough to definitely establish its existence as a distinct medical condition. Further research is needed to better understand the underlying causes of Morgellons and to develop more effective diagnostic treatment strategies. So, right there, again, they're saying that basically practitioners are believing one way or the other. And so the question is the evidence really so weak that doctors have to choose between what can be proven and what they think they know? It seems that if Morgellons is really real and the evidence demonstrates that it's really real, then that evidence should be held in high regard. But if the evidence is really real and it's published in prestigious medical journals, why isn't it accepted? Why do doctors fall back on their own beliefs rather than accepting the evidence? Well, let's continue on. I wanted to ask another question which may shed some light on that. So I asked, which studies have provided evidence that Morgellons is a real condition? And what it told me was several studies have provided evidence to suggest that Morgellons may be a real condition, although the evidence is not universally accepted. There's that word again. Some of these studies include a 2012 study published in the Journal of Clinical and Experimental Dermatology Research, which found that individuals with Morgellons had a higher prevalence of tick-borne infections, such as Borrelia burgdorferi, the bacterium that causes Lyme disease, than the general population. A 2013 study published in PLOS1, which analyzed skin samples from individuals with Morgellons, found that the fibers in the samples were composed of keratin and collagen, which are components of normal skin. A 2015 study published in the International Journal of Dermatology, which found that individuals with Morgellons had higher levels of inflammatory markers in their blood, suggesting that the condition may have an underlying immune dysfunction. A 2018 study published in Dermatologic Therapy, which reported that individuals with Morgellons had a higher prevalence of co-infections with various bacteria and viruses, as well as evidence of immune dysfunction compared to controls. While these studies provide some evidence to support the existence of Morgellons as a distinct medical condition, they are limited by small sample sizes and other methodological limitations. Further research is needed to better understand the underlying causes of Morgellons and to develop more effective diagnostic and treatment strategies. But then that's the question, though. Who are these strategies being developed for if doctors think the condition is entirely delusional and other doctors accept that it is a real condition? Which direction are those treatments going to be headed? And that's a question maybe you should go ask ChatGPT. So the next thing I wanted to know from ChatGPT's opinion on was, do some people mistakenly think they have Morgellons? And this is what it told me. Yes, it is possible for some people to mistakenly believe that they have Morgellons. Morgellons is a controversial condition that is characterized by the presence of unusual fibers or particles in and on the skin, as well as a range of other symptoms such as skin lesions, itching, crawling sensations, and fatigue. However, the symptoms of Morgellons can be similar to those of other medical or psychiatric conditions, such as delusional parasitosis, which is a psychiatric disorder characterized by a fixed, false belief of being infested with parasites. In some cases, individuals may mistake the symptoms of another condition for Morgellons and may seek out a diagnosis and treatment based on their belief that they have the condition. Additionally, because the cause of Morgellons is not well understood and the diagnosis and treatment of the condition can be controversial, some individuals may be more likely to self-diagnose with Morgellons based on their own research or experiences. It is important for individuals who are experiencing symptoms that they believe may be related to Morgellons or any other medical or psychiatric condition to seek out a professional medical evaluation and diagnoses from a qualified healthcare provider. Only a healthcare professional can provide a proper diagnosis and recommend appropriate treatment based on an individual's specific symptoms and medical history. Wow, that's interesting. So if a patient can mistakenly believe they have Morgellons, isn't it a doctor's job to let them know for sure if they do or do not? Well, I guess that comes down to if the doctor believes Morgellons is real or not. So I wanted to dive into that a little bit further and find out, okay, what is a doctor supposed to look for to know if a patient has Morgellons or not? What is the key diagnostic criteria for Morgellons is specifically what I asked ChatGPT. And what ChatGPT told me was Morgellons is a controversial condition, and there is no universally accepted set of diagnostic criteria for it. However, some healthcare providers may use the following criteria to diagnose Morgellons. Presence of unusual fibers or particles in or on the skin. Individuals with Morgellons typically report the presence of unusual fibers or particles in their skin, clothing, or other materials. These fibers may be black, white, blue, or red, and may be described as looking like threads, hairs, or specks of dust. Skin lesions. Individuals with Morgellons may also have skin lesions, such as sores, rashes, or scabs, that may or may not be related to the presence of fibers or particles. Other symptoms. Individuals with Morgellons may experience a range of other symptoms, such as itching, crawling sensations, fatigue, joint pain, and cognitive difficulties. It is important to note that the diagnosis of Morgellons is controversial, and some healthcare providers may be hesitant to diagnose the condition. In some cases, individuals who believe that they have Morgellons may benefit from seeking out a second opinion or consulting with a specialist in the diagnosis and treatment of the condition. It is also important for individuals who are experiencing symptoms to undergo a thorough medical evaluation to rule out other possible causes of their symptoms. So that was fascinating. Basically, there's a not accepted key diagnostic criteria, but it kind of goes into this whole thing about maybe you don't have Morgellons, but you need to go to a doctor. But the question is, what kind of doctor do you go to? It says you go to a specialist, but it didn't really elaborate on that. Again, I highly encourage everybody to go visit ChatGPT and have this same dialogue with the artificial intelligence so that it can learn what we know about Morgellons, and that can be factored into the responses that are given to people who are curious about the same information. But let's keep going on. I wanted to know, is Morgellons associated with syphilis? A question that weighs heavy on everyone's heart. And what ChatGPT told me was there is no direct association between Morgellons and syphilis. Although, the symptoms of Morgellons may sometimes overlap with those of syphilis or other medical conditions. Syphilis is a sexually transmitted infection caused by the bacterium Treponema pallidum. The symptoms of syphilis typically progress in stages, starting with a painless sore called a chancre at the site of infection and progressing to a rash, fever, sore throat, and other symptoms. Syphilis can effectively be treated with antibiotics if caught early. Morgellons, on the other hand, is a controversial condition characterized by the presence of unusual fibers or particles in and on the skin, as well as a range of other symptoms such as skin lesions, itching, crawling sensations, and fatigue. The cause of Morgellons is not well understood, and the diagnosis and treatment of the condition can be controversial. While there is no direct association between Morgellons and syphilis, some medical professionals have suggested that some individuals with Morgellons may actually be experiencing the symptoms of syphilis or another medical condition. It is important for individuals who are experiencing symptoms to undergo a thorough medical evaluation to rule out other possible causes of their symptoms. And I didn't like that answer, because I know that people have come to me and said, hey man, my doctor found syphilis and they didn't diagnose me with Morgellons. And it's not just one or two people. It's been several people that have told me this now. So I have anecdotal evidence, and I believe I have some empirical evidence that Morgellons may be associated with syphilis. I've seen some recent studies where there have been pictures which have been questionable. You know, maybe this skin lesion should be looked at a little more closely with a higher magnification. But on initial observation, it did give me the impression that Morgellons may be involved with this syphilis patient. So we'll have to, you know, like I said, we need more funding for research so we can find out, look, what percentage of syphilis patients do have Morgellons? It's not hard to round up a bunch of syphilis patients, because as far as I understand it, that's one of the highest transmissible diseases in the world. You know, people like to say in America, well, Lyme disease is the number one disease. No, it's not. It's one of the number one diseases. It's the number one vector-borne disease. So continuing on, I wanted to know how smart this ChatGPT was and how well-read in the research it actually gone. ChatGPT, I asked, what are Morgellons fibers made of? And ChatGPT responded to me by saying, the exact composition of the fibers found in individuals with Morgellons is a topic of debate and research. Some studies have suggested that the fibers may be composed of keratin and collagen, which are components of normal skin, hair, and nails. Other studies have found that the fibers contain cellulose or other plant-based materials, as well as synthetic materials, such as nylon or polyester. However, it is important to note that the presence of fibers in and on the skin does not necessarily indicate the presence of a distinct medical condition. There are many possible causes of fibers and other foreign objects becoming embedded in the skin, including environmental contaminants, clothing fibers, or other materials. Hey, if you're a member, I'm going to upload this here to the members section so you guys can see this episode first. It's not going to be edited, but I'm going to start giving you guys some of the raw footage for helping me out financially. That's a huge bonus, and I definitely appreciate you guys for it. So going forward, whenever we record an episode like this, y'all are going to see it first. While the cause and composition of Morgellons fibers are not well understood, it is important for individuals who are experiencing symptoms to undergo a thorough medical evaluation to rule out other possible causes of their symptoms. Only a healthcare professional can provide a proper diagnosis and recommend appropriate treatment based on an individual's specific symptoms and medical history. I thought that was a pretty decent answer, except, you know, of course, we wanted to know that the evidence is especially compelling that Morgellons is a real condition. I believe it is, based on what I've read and my ability to convert practitioners who have a different opinion. When people come to me and say, Morgellons is not real, why are you doing this? You know, you're just wasting your life. I go, yeah, I'm probably wasting my life, but I feel like I'm doing the right thing because, and then I can lay out the specific points in the studies which show them why I believe what I believe. And typically when I do that, they have to go, oh, wow, Morgellons really is a real condition. I mean, you may be still wasting your life, but at least you're trying to do the right thing. And they do go forward with a new understanding that, yeah, Morgellons is a distinct condition. It's not psychogenic in nature, and it is associated with Lyme disease. The evidence of that is compelling because they didn't just use one or two methods. They used several methods among a variety of universities, including Clemson University right here in South Carolina. One last question, guys. Is it ethical to diagnose someone with Morgellons if they do not have microscopic fibers embedded in their skin? And here's what ChatGPT said. Morgellons is a controversial condition, and there is no universally accepted set of diagnostic criteria for it. However, the presence of microscopic fibers embedded in or on the skin is often considered a hallmark feature of the condition. If an individual does not have microscopic fibers embedded in their skin, it would be difficult to make a diagnosis of Morgellons. In such a case, a healthcare professional would need to consider other possible causes of the individual's symptoms and conduct a thorough medical evaluation to rule out other medical or psychiatric conditions that could be causing their symptoms. It is important for healthcare professionals to use evidence-based diagnostic criteria and guidelines when evaluating and diagnosing any medical condition, including Morgellons. Making a diagnosis of Morgellons without clear evidence of microscopic fibers or other specific diagnostic criteria could potentially lead to inappropriate treatment and harm to the patient. It is also important for healthcare professionals to communicate clearly with patients about the diagnosis process and to provide them with accurate information about the condition and its treatment options. What do you guys think? Man, that's some craziness, isn't it? The ChatGPT. I want y'all to look that up and have this dialogue with ChatGPT yourselves. Let it know how you feel about these issues regarding Morgellons. Specifics. Ask them things that you thought about that I hadn't thought about when I was on there. And let me know in the comments what you asked and what the responses were. Together, we're going to make this a brighter world for Morgellons patients. Just hang around and see. What do you guys think? Let me know. Leave a blah, 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 blah. Talk to y'all soon and have a great day.